Welcome and good afternoon. This is lecture number 7 and video number 116. And today's video is based on hypothesis testing, and the objectives of today's presentation is to discuss F-test, testing omitted and irrelevant variables, and testing restrictions, that is specification tests. Let me give you an example of a regression model having k explanatory variables. To test the overall significance of the regression equation, the null and the alternative hypotheses can be written as H naught. And since we have beta 1, beta 2 up to beta k regression coefficients in this model, so the null hypothesis is that all these coefficients are equal to 0, and these are tested against an alternative hypothesis that at least one of these coefficients is not equal to 0. So H naught, alternative hypothesis is that H naught is not true. Now let us suppose this is a three variable case in which y is a dependent variable and x2 and x1 are explanatory variables. So here our null hypothesis is that both beta 1 and beta 2 are equal to 0, and our null hypothesis is that at least one variable is not 0. So we will compute and obtain F statistics, and then we will check for the critical value of the F statistics. These are the alpha is the level of significance, k is the number of independent variables, and n is the number of observations. Then we will compare the computed F test and the calculated F value. So if F star, that is the computed F value, is greater than the critical F, then it implies that we will reject the null hypothesis, and we would conclude that beta 1 and beta naught, beta 2 are not equal to 0. Larger F means higher explanatory power. So if the computed value of F is higher, then it means that the overall explanatory power of the model is great. So F test is a giant test. It is not used for significance of an individual coefficient, but for the overall model or overall equation or overall significance of the function. Here is the analysis of variance. We have total sum of square, then we have explained sum of square, and then we have residual sum of square. And this is the table. We have a regression sum of square. This is due to regression. And then we have due to residual, RSS, residual sum of square, and below there we have total sum of squares. And then we have mean sum of square due to regression, and mean sum of square due to residual, and so on. And F can be calculated as MSS of ESS, that is summation y hat square divided by k whole divided by regression sum of square, MSS of RSS, and that is RSS divided by n minus k minus 1. So finally we have this equation, summation y hat square divided by k whole divided by summation epsilon I hat square divided by n minus k minus 1. Our null hypothesis is that from beta 1 up to beta k they are all equal to 0, and our alternative is that beta 1 is not equal to 0, beta 2 is not equal to 0, up to beta k is not equal to 0. So the alternative hypothesis means that at least one of the betas is not equal to 0. So if f computed is greater than f calculated, then we will reject the null hypothesis, and our conclusion would be that all coefficients of regression or partial correlation or partial regression coefficients are not equal to 0. At least one of them is not equal to 0. There is an important relationship between R square and F. If you look at this equation, F is equal to explained sum of square divided by K whole divided by regression residual sum of square divided by N minus K minus 1, and that would be equal to ESS times n minus k minus 1 divided by RSS times k. So finally we have ESS divided by total sum of square minus exponent sum of square into n minus k minus 1 divided by k. And we have this equation. And finally, this will be simplified to r square divided by 1 minus r square into n minus k minus 1 divided by k. So f is equal to r square divided by k divided by 1 minus r square divided by n minus k minus 1. So for the three variable case, f is equal to r squared divided by 2 whole divided by 1 minus r squared divided by n minus 3. And similarly, we can reverse that r square is equal to kf divided by kf plus n minus k minus 1. So there is a very important relationship between the coefficient of determination and the f test. Then we have r squared and adjusted r squared. As you know, r squared, that is coefficient of determination, is the ratio of exponent sum of square divided by total sum of square. And we can write this as 1 minus RSS divided by total sum of square. So we have 1 minus summation epsilon I square divided by summation y square. And adjusted r square is equal to 1 minus summation epsilon hat square divided by n minus k minus 1 whole divided by summation y square divided by n minus 1, where k is the number of independent variables and n is the number of observations. So r squared, adjusted r squared, is equal to 1 minus alpha hat square divided by sigma square y, and r adjusted r square is then equal to 1 minus summation epsilon hat square divided by summation y square into n minus 1 divided by n minus k minus 1. So finally, adjusted r square is equal to 1 minus into 1 minus r squared into n minus k divided by n minus k minus 1. So it means that adjusted r square is either less than or equal to r square, whereas r squared lies between 0 and 1. 0 is less than r squared and r squared is less than 1. So it lies, it varies from 0 to 1, but usually it is less than 1 and greater than 0. Adjusted r square can also be negative. It could be less than or equal to 0. Here is the computer output of least square method regression, where y is the dependent variable, and there is a time series data from 1970 to 1982. So the total number of included observations is 13, and there are two variables x1 and x2. The coefficient of the constant is 7.19, its standard error is 1.59, its t statistic is equal to 4.51, and its p value shows that this is highly statistically significant because the p value is less than 0.05. The coefficient of x1 is negative and is equal to minus 1.39, and its standard error is 0.30, and its t statistic is minus 4.56. This is also significant. And the coefficient of x2 variable is 1.47, its standard error is 0.17, and its t statistic is 8.36, and its p value is also very low and highly significant. So the adjusted r square and r squared. R squared is equal to 0.87, meaning that it is almost 88% of the variation in the dependent variable y is explained by these two variables, and the adjusted r square is 0.85, and this is the standard error of regression, and this is the sum of squared residuals, this is the mean of the dependent variable, that is y bar, and this is the standard deviation of the dependent variable y. This is f statistic, and this is the probability value of the f statistic. So the overall f statistic shows that the overall regression equation of this model is significant statistically. This is the model, and then this is the estimated one, and this is equal to total sum of square divided by n minus 1 under root. Suppose x3 is not explanatory variable, but it is included in the regression. Now look at this model. Here we have again two explanatory variables and one dependent variable, and our null hypothesis is that beta 1 and beta 2 are equal to 0, and alternative is that beta 1 is not equal to 0, beta 2 is also not equal to 0. So we'll compare the computed F and the tabulated F from the F table. So our one F is this 6.93 and one is 3.92. So this is our F computed. So the decision rule is, since F star, that is computed F, is greater than F critical or the tabulated, so we will reject the null hypothesis. So the answer is that the overall estimators are statistically significant and different from zero. Instead of using the F computed and F calculated and comparing the values, we may also conclude on the basis of the p value of the F state. If the p value of the F state is less than 0.05, then we will reject the null hypothesis, and we will conclude that at least one of the beta is not equal to zero. Testing the overall significance of multiple regression. Again, we take the case of three variables, and this time we have beta 1 hat x1 and beta 2 hat x and epsilon hat. So total sum of square is equal to explained sum of square. This is explained sum of square, and this is residual sum of square, and here is the ANOVA table. Explained sum of square is this, residual sum of square is this, and total sum of square is this, and these are the degrees of freedom, and this is the mean sum of square, and explained sum of square divided by 2, and this is a residual sum of square divided by n minus 2 minus 1. The F statistic will be like this. So if we put the numerical estimates of these values, then we can get the value of F test. So again, let us suppose the dependent variable is the pharmaceutical price level. The method is least square. The sample is 32 observations, based on 32 observations. The GDP, this is the per capita GDP, and this is the per capita consumption, and this is the patents are recognized equal to 1 PP. So this is a kind of dummy variable, and this is the standard deviation of the dependent variable. This is the standard error of regression, and this is a sum of squared residual, and this is the R squared. Almost 73% of the variation in the dependent variable is explained by this model. This is adjusted R square. Here is the F statistic, and its p value is 0.00000. So it means that we strongly reject the null hypothesis. The coefficients of these variables are equal to zero. So we conclude that the overall model is statistically significant, and at least one of these coefficients is not equal to zero. And this is also confirmed by the t state and the p values. So two of the betas are not equal to zero, and one is equal to zero, because this is not significant. Since sigma hat square of y is equal to variance of y, and that is equal to summation y hat square divided by n minus 1, and that implies that n minus 1 into sigma hat y square is equal to sigma hat square. And here is the ANOVA table, information from EU's results, and these are the numerical values. This is the explained sum of square, this is residual sum of square, and this is total sum of squares. This is total sum of squares, total sum of squares, residual sum of squares, and explained sum of squares, and these are the degrees of freedom. And since sigma square y is equal to y variance of y, and that is equal to this, so finally f computed is equal to 25.5. 191. If we substitute these values in the formula of F, then we get this. So this value is coming from here and this value is coming from here, and if we simplify this, we get this. So this is the computed value of F, and that is 25.191. Let me check this in the table. This is exactly the same as we calculated manually. So the computer software output is exactly the same, the F statistics, and this value is also the same here in this slide, this one. And this is the critical values of F statistic, 5% table of significance. So F, the tabulated value of F at 5%, 2 and 2, number of observation is 12, and degrees of freedom is 2. So we have this value 3.89. So this is the tabulated value, and this is the F computed value. So this is greater than the tabulated value, so it implies that we strongly reject H naught, and we will conclude that at least one of the coefficient or the estimate of the true parameter is not equal to zero. This is again at 1% level, and at 1% level the F tabulated is 6.93, and the F computed is this. So again, computed or calculated F value is greater than the tabulated value at 1% level, so we will reject H naught. So the model, the overall model, is statistically highly significant. This is also the overall significance test, picking restaurant locations. This is the dependent variable, gross sales, and here is the competition. This is the population, and this is income, and these are the coefficients, and here is the F state. The value is equal to 15.65, and its p value is 0.000003, and this is significant. So we will conclude that the overall equation is highly statistically significant. And again, if we put values in this formula, then the computed F is also equal to 15.648, and it is also here 15.648, and critical value of F is 2.92. So computed value of F is greater than tabulated value of F, so we will reject the null, and we conclude that this model is statistically significant. All of the three explanatory variables are significant, keeping in view these p values and t statistics. Here is the ANOVA, and using these values from ANOVA, if we put this value and this value in the formula, then we get 15.6489 as the computed value of F. Specification error and testing. Usually researchers and students commit some mistakes. Sometimes they omit important variables, and sometimes they include irrelevant variables in the model. So consequences of omission of an important variable in the true model, we follow like this. Let us suppose the true model is that y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus epsilon, and we assume that the expected value of epsilon is equal to 0, and the covariance of x1 and epsilon is equal to 0. So the expected value of beta 1 hat is equal to true beta 1. But the wrong estimated model is like this. We omitted an important variable, say for example x2. Now we have beta naught star and beta 1 star xi plus vi, where expected value of vi is not equal to 0, because the covariance of x1 and v is not equal to 0, because it also includes another variable x2. So the results with biased estimator is that the expected value of beta 1 hat star will not be equal to true beta 1. Okay, so if we omit an important variable in the model, then there will be biased estimator. Then it will result in biased estimate, biased OLS estimator. That's not good. So from the estimated model, V is equal to beta 2 x2 plus epsilon. So that means that the error term also includes one variable which is important determinant of the dependent variable, but we have not included in this model. And from 1, expected value of V is equal to expected value of beta 2 x2 plus epsilon, and that is equal to expected value of beta 2 x2 plus expected value of epsilon is equal to 0, but expected value of beta 2 x2 is not equal to 0. Similarly, the covariance between x1 and v, that is covariance of x1 and beta 2 x2 plus epsilon is equal to beta 2 covariance of x1 x2 plus covariance of x1 epsilon, and then finally beta 2 covariance of x1 x2 is not equal to 0. So these two properties violate OLS assumptions. Therefore, estimators are not blue, and blue means best linear unbiased estimators. So the bias beta 2 alpha 1, where alpha 1 is from regression, x2 is equal to x0 plus x1 x1 plus ui. So the bias exists unless, number one, the true coefficient equals 0, are the included and omitted variables are uncorrelated. Unconstrained model. Let us suppose our model is yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 I plus beta 2 x2 I plus beta 3 x3 I plus epsilon I. And the constraint models are like this. Test the irrelevant variables. Beta 1 is equal to 0. Yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 I, beta 2 x2 I plus beta 3 x3 I plus epsilon. Our null hypothesis is, say for example, that beta 2 and beta 3 are equal to 0. Then in that case we have the model yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 I plus epsilon I, because we assume that beta 2 and beta 3 are equal to 0. And in the first model we assume that beta 1 is equal to 0. So beta k is equal to 0 for k is equal to 1, 2, 3. If yes, this is the last case. So if we include non-influential variable, the true model is that beta naught star plus beta 1 star x plus epsilon, but we misspecified and we also included another variable z. And we found out that expected value of beta 2 hat is equal to 0. So the consequences are that from OLS, beta 1 hat star is equal to summation x y summation x I square, and the variance of beta 1 hat star is equal to sigma square hat epsilon divided by summation x square. And from OLS, beta 1 hat is equal to summation xy into summation z square minus summation yz into summation xz whole divided by summation x square into summation z square minus summation xz whole square, and z is equal to z minus z bar, that is in deviation from, so variance of beta 1 hat star is equal to sigma square v hat divided by summation x square into 1 minus coefficient of correlation of x and z. Now testing an additional variable in the regression model. Let us suppose that the true model is the restricted one, that is y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x1 plus epsilon I. Obtain r squared of the restricted model, r residual sum of square of the restricted model, and r exponent sum of square of the restricted model. Now we consider a new variable x2, whether it is relevant to it or not. We will use unconstrained model or unrestricted model, and here the difference is that in the above model there is only one variable x1, but in this model there are two variables x1 and x2. So we will now obtain r squared of the unrestricted model, or the residual sum of square of the unrestricted and expanded sum of square of the unrestricted model, and we will test the hypothesis that beta 2 is equal to 0 and x2 is not relevant, or beta 2 is not equal to 0, then we will add x2 is relevant. Now, steps of testing whether x2 has an incremental contribution of the explanatory power in the model. So compute the F state, and the F state will be obtained by this formula, that is equal to residual sum of square of the restricted model minus residual sum of square of the unrestricted model divided by M and number of constants whole divided by residual sum of square of the unrestricted model divided by N minus K minus 1. These are the number of parameters in the new model, N minus 3. So now we will compare the computed value and the critical value of F, and the decision rule is that if computed value of F is greater than the tabulated value of F, then it implies that we will reject H naught and beta 2 is equal to beta 2 is not equal to 0, and that means that X2 is a relevant variable to be added into the model. So here, instead of equal, this is not equal, that should not be equal to 0 if computed F is greater than the tabulated F. Now use the R squared instead of expanded sum of square or residual sum of square in the F test. So restriction test is this, that F star is equal to RSS of the restricted model, then RSS of the unrestricted model divided by number of constants, constant variables, whole divided by restricted sum, residual sum of square of the unrestricted model divided by N minus K minus 1. That is number of parameters in the new model. So R square is equal to 1 minus residual sum of square divided by total sum of square. So here we also divide this by this and this by this and also this by this. So F star can also be calculated by R square, and here is this formula for R, and finally this. So looking at this computer output, the dependent variable is the y, the method is least square, and we have these variables, the residual sum of square of the unrestricted model is 143.07, and the r squared of the unrestricted model is 0.9903, and we have this f that is equal to 5.195. And this is the tabulated value of F. So since F tabulated is greater than F F tabulated, so we reject H naught, and we conclude that beta 2 is not equal to 0. Add an irrelevant variable R, that is interest rate. Then in that case, again we can compute the value of F, which is equal to this 0.3764, and the difference between the computed value and the tabulated value is equal to 4.17. so we will not reject H naught, we fail to reject H naught, and this time we conclude that R is irrelevant. Add variables in the general discussion. Let us suppose this is the old model, restricted one, and this is the unrestricted one, in which we included two more variables. Now in this case, testing the two additional variables XLM, whether they are relevant or not, we are going to use a F test, that is beta with subscript L and beta with subscript M. Both of them are equal to 0, and alternative is they are not equal to 0. So here we use this F, and it's kind of a wall test. So if F computed is greater than F tabulated, we will reject the null that these two coefficients are equal to 0. If F computed is less than F tabulated, then we will fail to reject this. Again, drop variables in the discussion. If the old model is this and the new one is this, this one is unrestricted and this one is restricted. in this case again we test this hypothesis against the null hypothesis, and so we will test this null hypothesis, and to test the dropping of two variables XL, XM, whether they are relevant or not, we test this null hypothesis against this alternative hypothesis, and we will use this computed F formula, and if F computed is greater than F tabulated, then we will reject H0, otherwise we will fail to reject H0. Now justify whether or keep or to drop XL and XM in the model. Theory is check the sign of beta 1, beta L hat and beta M hat, whether the variables are theoretically explaining or logical justification the dependent variables. So overall fitness is check adjusted R square. If it increases or decreases, check F computed statistic whether it increases or decreases. Check T statistic of XL and XM whether TL star and TM star are greater than 1.96, that is 0.05 level of significance. And then bias, check T test of other variables X2 up to XK whether they have changed significantly or not. If they have changed significantly, then there is bias in the T statistics. And then we can use Ramsey regression specification error test, and the Ramsey reset test is a general test which determines the likelihood of an omitted variable or some other specification error by measuring whether the fit of a given equation can be significantly improved by adding y2 hat, y3 hat, and y4 hat terms. So this test involves three steps. Estimate the equation to be estimated using OLS. That is why I hat is equal to beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat x1i plus beta 2 hat x2i. This is the restricted model. And take the fitted estimated model of yu and create yi hat squared, yi hat cube, yi hat 4 raised to the power 4 terms. Then add these terms to the equation and estimate the new equation. And that is the unrestricted model in which y appears as a squared, as a cube, and as raised to the power 4, and test the hypothesis that the coefficient of all the three added terms are equal to 0, that is beta 3 is equal to beta 4 is equal to beta 5 is equal to 0, and H1 is that the null hypothesis is not true. Then calculate F statistic and compare the critical to the critical F, and if calculated or if computed is greater than the F tabulated, then reject H0, otherwise we will fail to reject H0. Testing the partial coefficient under some restrictions, this is the first one is the Cope-Douglas production function, and then we use the restricted least square constant return to scale, that is beta 1 and beta 2 are equal to 0. Beta 1, then beta 1 is equal to 1 minus beta 2, and beta 2 is equal to 1 minus beta 1. Then take the log of the above equation, we will get natural log of y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1, natural log of L1 and beta 2, natural log of k2 plus epsilon. And following this procedure, finally we have y star is equal to beta naught, beta prime hat, beta naught prime, beta 2 prime, x star plus epsilon prime. So this is the restricted model, and the above one is the unrestricted model. And then we compare the computer output of the unrestricted model and the restricted model, and we compare the sum of squared residual. The sum of squared residual in the unrestricted equation is 0.1583, and the sum of squared residual in the restricted equation is 0.23 2758, and our null hypothesis is that beta 1 plus beta 2 is equal to 0. Our alternative is that it is either less than or greater than 0, and this is the F formula, and the F value is equal to 11.27, 11.27, and the F tabulated value is 4.26. So the computed F is greater than the calculated. So we will reject the null hypothesis and we will conclude that the sum of beta 1 and beta 2 is not equal to 1. So follow this, the unrestricted and the restricted model, and here again is the output again, and test for restriction on parameters. Unrestricted model, we can say beta 1 is equal to beta 2, or beta 1 minus beta 2 is equal to theta is equal to 0, or as beta 1 is equal to theta plus beta 2 is equal to 0. So we will compute test beta 1 hat minus beta 2 hat divided by standard error of the difference of the beta 1 hat minus beta 2 hat, and we will compare to tabulated t, and we will follow t test decision rule. Next, rewrite the equation like this, and finally we will have restricted model like y is equal to beta 0 plus theta 1 x 1 plus beta 2 x 2 star plus epsilon prime, and this simply use the t value to test whether theta is equal to 0 or not. And this is the example of the computer output of the unrestricted model. So f star is f star means the computed f is equal to 0, but the critical value of f is 2.37. this is for the restricted model, and here t tabulated is 1.96. So since this computed value of f is less than this and this, so we fail to reject the null hypothesis. We fail to reject the null hypothesis. So theta is not equal to 0. Are two sample groups equal? Suppose there are two sample groups of data. Group A, yi, y2i up to xai, where I varies from 1 to n, and then there is another group B, in which yj varies yj and x2j up to xkj, where j varies from nj up to capital N. If the relation between x and y are different, then yi is equal to lambda naught plus lambda 1 x1i plus up to lambda k xki plus epsilon 1i, where I varies from 1 to up to n, and then yj we have gamma naught plus gamma 1 x1j plus up to gamma k xkj plus epsilon 2i, and here j varies from nj up to capital N. If the relation between x and y is identical for both the groups, then we have equation number 3, and that is yi is equal to alpha naught plus alpha 1 x1i plus up to alpha k plus alpha k xki plus epsilon I, where I varies from 1 to capital N. So these are the number of observation. N1 is for the first group, N2 is for the second group, and capital N is the sum of N1 plus N2. So should the two groups be treated as one group or not? So the null hypothesis is that lambda k is equal to gamma k, where k varies from 0 up to capital K. And the alternative hypothesis is that lambda k is not equal to gamma k for at least 1k. So we will estimate equation 1 and equation 2 to get residual sum of square of the first equation and residual sum of square of the second equation, and then we will have the residual sum of square of the unrestricted model, which will be the sum of residual sum of square for the first model plus residual sum of square for the second model, and then we will estimate equation 3 to get RSSR, that is the residual sum of square for the restricted model. So we will use this Chow test or structural stability test. So H0 is that no structural change, that is variance of epsilon 1 is equal to variance of epsilon 2, and both of them are equal to constant variance sigma square. And H1 is yes, there is a structural change, that is variance of epsilon 1 is not equal to variance of epsilon 2, and that is not equal to constant variance sigma square. So the procedure is divide the sample of n observation into two groups. Group 1 consists of first n1 observation, group 2 consists of the remaining N2 is equal to capital N minus N1 observation, and then we will run the ORS on the two subsample groups separately and obtain RSS1 and RSS2, where RSS1 plus RSS2 is equal to RSS1 for the unrestricted model. Then we will run OLS on the whole sample and obtain the restricted residual sum of square RSSR, and then we will compute by putting these values in the formula, and finally we will compute the computed value of F, and we can compare that with the tabulated value of F, and if the computed value of F is greater than the tabulated value of F, then we will reject H0, and it means that there is structural change in the sample. And example in this book is in table 6.2, and here we have whole sample 1960 up to 69, and these are the values of the variables, the green line, the red line, the blue line, the red line, the green line, and the black. This is for subsample 1960 to 1979, and this is for another sample. So if we use this equation and run subsample of N1 regression, this is the RSS1. Similarly, this is RSS2 for the second model, and then this is the whole sample N regression RSSR restricted, and here are the empirical results. This is the residual sum of square from the restricted whole sample. This is the residual sum of square from sample 1. This is residual sum of square from sample 2, and we have this F formula, and put values from this here, we get that F star are the computed value of F is equal to 5.07, and since F star, that is computed value of F, is greater than tabulated value of F, so it means that we will reject H0, and this is the F critical for the first, this is F critical for the second, so we will reject the null hypothesis. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a brief discussion about hypothesis testing using F-test for testing the omitted and irrelevant variables, and then some restriction test and specification test. And we also use the wall test, whether we should use the whole sample or we should subdivide the whole sample into two samples. Ladies and gentlemen, if you like this video, kindly do share with your friends, with your colleagues, with your students, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon so that you can get notification about my other videos that I will upload subsequently. Thank you, and have a good afternoon.